I'm so excited to be back. I had a huge revelation since the last time I was here. I realized that I'm envious of children. They have so much that I didn't have when I was a kid. They have cool toys, cool clothes, parents that have heard of therapy. I was hanging out with a little three-year-old friend not that long ago. Don't get weird about it. Her mom was my friend, and then she got born. I didn't go out of my way to make a three-year-old just follow her little light-up shoes, like, hey, do you want to hang out? She just got into the situation. I was reading a book with her. It was called Feelings Are Fine, Feel 'em. And it had 50 different little cartoon faces, expressions. The whole point of the book was to identify and talk about feelings. She's getting this information hardwired into her tender brain at age 3. When I tell you, I was learning from the book in real time. Just the title, I was like, feelings are what? Fine? And there's 50 of them? No way there's 50 of them. When I was a kid, we knew about two feelings. We knew about happy and shut the fuck up. That's all we had, and we were doing better than our parents. They had one feeling, shut the fuck up. Their parents, our grandparents, had to donate their feelings to the war effort. They couldn't afford feelings. Just wasn't on their radar. Kids are so cool now. They're so on top of it with gender, with everything. I don't know about my sense of my own gender is ever evolving. People would say non-binary or agender, whatever. If you have a good spirit in your heart, I'll take anything. Any combination of words that makes sense to you makes sense to me. If you have a good spirit in your heart, anything. Failed woman, fine. Weird man, all right. Chiweeny in a tank top, I admire your creativity and you're close to the vibe. I find it funny when people can't wrap their heads around they-them pronouns, though. I understand if it's new or if you mess it up, but to pretend it's about grammar, you know these people, right? They're like, I can't say they-them because it's plural, and it just sounds funny to me because it's plural. You said the word staycation last week, Cheryl. Clearly you understand that language evolves. Chillax. I like when they pretend it's about grammar, though. Are you kidding me? That's my wheelhouse. Look at me. I'm like, oh, you care about grammar all of a sudden? Cool. Explain to me the difference between farther and further. Let's dance, Cheryl. Let's go. Oh, you're walking farther and farther away from me the further I get into this conversation? I'm just saying the name Cheryl, by the way. I don't know. In my mind, Cheryls are the Susans of Karens, if that makes sense to anybody. And people wonder sometimes, like, what's between the legs of a they-them? I will tell you right now, what's between the legs of a they-them? 9 times out of 10, it's a rescue chihuahua trying to get warm. That's all that's happening. Just a small, shivering dog wrapped in the warm, powerful thighs of a they-them. Person plus dog, is that plural enough for you, Cheryl? One last thing before I go, just to recap my pronouns, they, them, they're there, because I need to be comforted for unrelated reasons.